Everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome. I see so many homeschooled students' faces. That makes me so happy. Extra credit is a real thing. I just want to let you guys know that. Kimmy liked that one. Kimmy's laughing at my joke. A little dad joke going on over here. I am a dad of three now. Well, welcome, everybody. Today is going to be a lot of fun. So we're going to give it a couple seconds while everybody hops on. But if you guys could please take a moment, put in the chat where everybody's located today. I'm here in Newport Beach, California. Mr. Adam Quick, what's up, buddy? Tampa, Atlanta, North Carolina. I got houses in all those places. Pretty neat. New Jersey, Alaska, Houston, Memphis, Maine. All right, look at that. New Mexico, Maryland, Lakewood, San Diego, Philadelphia. All right, all over the country.
Harry came in and put his hand up right away. I love that. He's like, just in case we take Q&A, I'm getting in first. By the way, homeschool, look, we're at the home offices this week. The whole team is here. What's up? Wave to the home team. Love it.
Yeah, it was nice seeing everybody today. I actually was filming at the office today, so I got to get a little bit of work done. It was nice.
We still got people coming into our we'll get ready just about.
Yeah, right. We'll give it a minute. So I guess let's just start talking while we're waiting. Where should we call first? And by the way, everybody, so this is something very important to understand. The entire reason I'm doing what I'm doing tonight is to show you guys that with nothing more than a phone and the internet, you can get deals. You hear so many reasons of why you can't get deals and you don't have money. You don't need any of those things. Here's how real estate investing works. If you have a deal, you can buy it yourself if you have money. If you have a deal and you have $0 to your name, you can sell it to someone like me and we'll pay you money. And that's called wholesaling real estate. So obviously, I know of better techniques than what I'm going to be showing you guys tonight to get deals. But a lot of those techniques, they might cost money. So today is just to show you for free, with nothing more than the internet and a phone, you can become a real estate investor. So as the time goes on, I'm going to be asking, do you guys think you can do this? So I do, before we kick this off, and I want to hear from you guys, what are the reasons why you think you aren't or you can't be a real estate investor? I just want to look at that really quick. What are the reasons that you think you can't be a real estate investor? I'm very curious because so funds, you don't need funds to be a real estate investor. You don't need money. You can wholesale real estate. See, it's all funding. And that's why it's important to learn, you guys. It's important to get the education because you're assuming something, but you don't have the facts. And if you assume things in life without getting the facts, it's impossible to make progress. I tell everybody all the time, the last thing you'll ever see me do is assume something. I want it yes or no, black or white, and I'm going to test it and prove it, and I'm never going to assume it. So today is about putting your guard down, listening to what we're saying, and understanding this. It does not take money to get involved in real estate investing. Mike, how much money outside of my cell phone am I going to be spending tonight making phone calls looking for deals?
None.
Okay, none. So you guys, I want you to watch what I'm doing tonight. And then I want you to ask yourself, can I do what Tarek does? If you think you can over time, well, guess what? You just convinced yourself that you're going to be a real estate investor. We're going to keep it as simple as that. I'm here tonight to prove to you that you can do it. This isn't for me, you guys. I've already flipped a lot of houses. This is for you guys, because I know a lot of you have been thinking about doing this for years. A lot of you, you read books, you watch videos, and you just haven't taken that first step. Okay. So let's remove the limiting beliefs. Okay. Let's throw out the fixed mindset. And tonight's about a growth mindset. And here's the thing about humans, right? We're built under pressure. humans evolve, develop, grow under stress, under pain. If you look at the human body, what happens when you do physical exercise, when you're lifting weights, what happens to your body? Your muscle builds, because when you're lifting weights, you're not building muscle. When you're lifting weights, you're actually tearing your muscles. You're ripping your muscles. And then while you recover, those little tears and those little rips, they come back together stronger and bigger than before. There's no difference with real estate investing. It's a compound interest game. Let me give you another example. If I went to the gym my very first day, I lifted weights, I did cardio, am I going to see any results? No, no. If I went to the gym 6 days a week, I ate a clean diet, took my supplements, would I see results in 6 months? Yes, 100% chance, yes. Now, real estate investing. Am I going to get a deal tonight? Maybe, probably not, but maybe. If I did this every night for 6 months, am I going to get a deal? Yes, I am. And how do I know that? Well, I've proven it over and over again. So you guys, be vocal in the chat. I'm here to help you. This is a free training. I really want to open your eyes to what's possible, because our entire lives we're lied to about what we're capable of from our friends, our parents, our coworkers. And the reason they lied to us is because they didn't know any better, because people lied to them. See, I was the one, you know, when I was 19 years old, I was tired of being lied to. And I said, I'm going to figure this out. And I dedicated my life, you guys, to becoming an entrepreneur. And the first 10 years were the most miserable 10 years you could ever experience or endure. And I'm glad I endured it, because the lessons I learned through 10 years of grinding are invaluable. And now I can take all that experience with me for the rest of my life. And here's another beautiful thing about real estate investing for all of you. Once you get it, you got it. What does that mean? Once you finally figure it out, oh, I can do this, you have it for the rest of your life. And here's another beautiful thing about real estate. Home values today and rents today, 10 years from now, they're going to be higher. 15 years from now, they're going to be higher. 20 years from now, they're going to be higher. So imagine if you got in now, and I'm not saying you have to be a psychopath like me and work a zillion hours a week. Let's just say you got in, you did a couple deals a year, and you bought two or three rentals a year over the next 7 years. What happens in 15 or 18 years from now if you have 20 paid off houses bringing you $50,000, $60,000 a month for the rest of your life? Who wants that? I am here to tell you it is possible. I'm doing it. Actually, I'm beyond that. I've done that. You guys can do this too. The only reason you're not going to do this is if you choose not to do it. And the only reason you're going to choose not to do it is if you don't believe you can do it. And the only reason you'll believe you can't do it is that means I did a crappy job tonight. So hopefully that doesn't happen. So with that being said, here's what we're going to do. To show you, I have no prep. I don't even know where we're calling yet, you guys. We're going to call right off of Zillow. So you guys could use Zillow. You could use Redfin. You could use Realtor.com. But here's the thing. We're going to be cold calling real estate agents. And here's something you need to understand. I'm not necessarily calling the agent about the property they're listing. I'm calling about the property they're listing so I can start a conversation. Then from that conversation, I try to build a relationship. And through that relationship, we try to get future referrals. Does that make sense, everybody? Get a couple of head bobs, yeah? Okay, great. All right, Mike, let's kick this thing off. Where should we start first? Because it's a little late on the East Coast. Should we hit West Coast? What
do we do? We got one or two on the East Coast. We found a couple awesome properties on Zillow in Savannah, Georgia. Grayson, who was on the call. Grayson's around here somewhere pulling deals as usual. There he is. So Grayson, one of our chief strategists here, is pulling some deals, and we found a couple great deals. One is a definite fixer-upper, but I think we're going to go ahead and share so you can see the deals. Our first one is here. We had a recent price cut. It's a three-bedroom, three-bath price cut on the 14th. By 50 grand. So probably a motivated seller. And we've got the name of the realtor right here highlighted.
Yeah. So everybody, so here's some important things when you guys are doing this. Okay. Here's what you want to look for. The first thing you want to look for is days on market. How long has this house been on the market? Okay. The second thing you're going to look for is price reductions. So if you see a house that's been on the market 180 days and they never drop their price, they're probably not that motivated. If you have a house that's been on the market 180 days and they've dropped their price three times, do you guys think there's more motivation in there? There's more motivation. So look at your days on market and price reductions. So this one, it's newer days on market, price cut 49,000. All right, well, let's call them up. Who's ready? Who are we calling? Elena Sells. Is that a real name? That's a cool name for a realtor. I like that. 415-5977. All right, let the games begin.
Your call has been forwarded.
All right. So they didn't answer. So now. Hi, Elena. My name is Tarek El Moussa. I am interested in purchasing your listing at 822 West 39th Street in Savannah, Georgia. Please give me a ring when you can or shoot me a text. Thank you. All right. Who's next? Wow, that's a real fixer-upper right there. It's like a house of horrors. What is this thing?
Listen, oh, every once in a while, Grayson finds a good one, a nice piece of needing support.
Yeah. Oh, man, if you guys would have saw this house I just bought, I walked it last week. Wow, worse than this. All right, so this one, no data. So normally, I wouldn't even mess around with this price point because it's too low. So here's something you got to understand. If you buy a $100,000 house, fix it up and sell it, or you buy $1 million house, fix it up and sell it, the work's the same, the profit's much different. So you have to choose where you spend your time very wisely. All right, is there a number for this one?
Funny enough, it's the same realtor. We didn't even see that. Sorry, Tarek. Oh, that's hilarious.
It's probably the same owner too.
Let me see. It is the same number. Because I did a search to see if we could find. I have the direct number. I also have the broker's. Maybe we don't want to call it brokerage.
Nah.
That looks like Elena's direct number. I don't know if you want to call it back.
Yeah, that was her direct number. I guess I can blow her up one more time. Why not?
Let's see if after listening, if she picks up.
Hello?
Hi, is this Elena?
This is.
Hey, Elena, this is Tarek El Moussa. How are you?
I'm good. How about yourself?
I'm doing pretty good. I just called you a moment ago on 822 West 39th Street in Savannah, Georgia.
Yep.
And I just noticed you have another one listed. Let me get that address for you real quick. 1018 West 45th Street.
Yep.
Okay. Are those the same owner by any chance?
No, they're not.
They're actually not. Okay. Well, I'm interested in purchasing the properties. Maybe we could talk about 39th Street first. Is that one still available?
It is still available. We are just waiting on the professional pictures from the photographer. Yep.
Okay, great. And looking, and do you have any offers on the property right now?
Not yet, but one of them has been completely renovated. Everything is brand new from Orange Film Plumbing, HVAC. Everything inside out. And the other one 45th or 41st Street is nothing has been done to it. So it needs everything.
Got, okay, so 39th Street was actually just remodeled then.
Correct.
Okay, yep. Got it. So 45th Street needs remodel. So obviously you've seen the house and I haven't. So like based on your expert opinion, how much do you think it would cost to make this, to clean this house up and get it fixed up nice? New kitchen, new bathroom, new flooring, new paint.
Around 100,000.
So you think about 100,000. And what would a fixed up 1,253 square foot house for sell for in this neighborhood?
Around 300.
Okay.
It's a nice street. It's a clean street. It's, you know, just, you know, good neighbors where they upkeep their properties, know all that stuff.
So got it. Okay. So you think about 100,000 to fix it up and you think the value would be around 300,000.
$300,000-$325,000 depending, you know, the finishes, obviously.
Yeah, of course.
A22 is really nice. Really nice. So it's got, you know, it's got a great design. It's three bedrooms, three bathrooms. It's, you know, it's just great stuff. You know, they didn't put like the basic tile.
Yeah.
Basic, you know, like white or gray stuff. You know, they actually went with the vision, great banks, he sold that stuff. So if you put basic, I would say 300,000 for the other.
Yeah, so I'm just a little bit curious because I live in California and I buy all over the country. Yep. If someone could buy this house for 100 and put 100 into it, how is it not sold yet?
So first off, it was bought at a tax sale. So it needs to be, the quiet title needs to be done. So my seller for that one is selling it as is. Secondly, again, a lot of the stuff is structural stuff. So when it comes down in Savannah, Georgia to structural stuff, like plumbing, electric, HVAC, framing, you know, reconfiguring the floor plan, a lot of the buyers are just scared because they don't have the know-how. So the guys that they work with, they've done it over and over and over again. So they're not scared. They're the opposite.
Got it. Okay. And then price-wise, I mean, what kind of a price would you think your seller's looking for on this?
I mean, they're looking close to asking. So they bought it at the tax sale. They've got a number of inventories. They're investors. So they've got a number of properties also all over the country. So at this rate, they're just trying to liquidate this for as is value. Just make money, you know, and move on.
Got it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I'd have to run some numbers on this one, but it sounds like you work with a pretty big investor group. I buy about 20 to 30 houses a month. And if they're looking to unload inventory instead of listing, I'd love to just buy direct cash. Is that something they might be open to?
Not on that particular one, but yes, I do have, you know, stuff that it is not listed. So if you want to text me your email address, I'd be more than happy to mark your email and use the properties.
Okay, I'm going to text you my email address right now. And I'm 100% legit. Like I really buy 20, 30 houses a month. So I'm the real deal. And I'd love to do some deals with you.
Absolutely. I'd love to work with you too.
Okay. And then you already said you're going to send me some deals. So, okay. That's perfect. So yeah. I'll shoot you my email address right now.
Excellent. Sounds good. And first thing in the morning, I'll sit down at my computer and look what they have available off market. And then I'll send that over.
Okay, but hey, Elena, I got a quick question. Have you ever seen a show called Flip or Flop on HGTV?
I have.
Yeah, that's me, Tarek. I was the guy with the blonde wife.
Hey, Tarek.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah, so I'd love to do some deals with you. I'm looking all over. So, yeah, please let me know.
That would be amazing. But why do you not move in the Savannah market? You guys could totally recreate what you do there and have a massive amount of success.
Well, me and all of my students, we're planning on taking over the whole country. You just got to be patient. We're trying.
I'd love, and if you're ever in the area, I'd love to meet the kind of, you know, work with that. Like, again, I work primarily with investors. So like on and off, I onload about 80 properties a year, literally just investor prone properties.
Awesome.
A lot of that stuff, it's either, you know, historic or just regular, you know,
yeah,
very simple stuff. So but
yeah
I mean, the pool in Savannah, I mean, it would be a great market for you guys.
Okay, well, really excited to do some deals there. And then on top of flipping and wholesaling, I also buy rentals, so we have different options. So I'll definitely take a look at everything you send me.
Sounds good.
All right, Elena, thank you.
Awesome. Have a great night. Thanks.
You too. Oh, we got a mic drop, guys. Come on. How that was like, listen, it doesn't get much better than that. But here's what I want. Something for you guys to realize. I went into the call acting like I had zero knowledge or experience. Did you guys notice? I asked the realtor how much it's going to cost to fix up the house. And she told me. And then I asked the realtor, how much do you think it could sell for? And then she told me. So that's what I'm saying, you guys. Most people come from jobs. This isn't a job. This is real estate. You know what real estate is? It's pay to play, or play to pay, or whatever that term is. Meaning everybody's on commission, right? So everybody wants to help you. You call a loan officer, they're going to teach you about loans. You call a realtor, they're going to teach you about real estate. You kind of call a title rep, they're going to teach you about title, because this is a commission industry. So Mike, did you see how I did that? She told me how much the rehab would be, and she told me what it would sell for. Like, it doesn't get much better than that. And here's the beautiful thing. She sells 80 houses a year, and she works with investors. I can almost guarantee you guys, I'm going to buy a deal from that call.
Yeah.
Now, I want to see hands up. Does anyone think they can make that call and ask those questions? I see a couple of hands.
Most hands are up, Tarek.
Listen, all you have to do is take this recording, listen to it again, write down the questions I asked, practice the questions in the mirror, and then go start talking to people. That's it. You become an entrepreneur overnight. I'm telling you guys, it works. Just have faith, believe in it. All right, we got to call another one. That was a fun call, you guys.
Hey, Tark, somebody just threw an audible. I want to look at a property. I think I just sent it to you. Did you grab that? Yeah, in Washington. Dominique, first of all, Dominique, thank you for sending that in.
Yeah.
Property in Seattle, Washington.
Yeah, and real quick, Mike, sorry, not to interrupt. So someone asked, do we need an agent? My agent is the agent that I called, because if I wanted to buy the house, I would say, can you represent me in writing an offer? 99% of the time, they're going to say yes, because they want both sides of the commission.
All right. So, Targ, one of our participants, Dominique, threw this in, and I pulled it up. I saw the price cut, the size, the price. It's right in a great section in Seattle. It looks like there's development happening all around it. So I thought it'd be a very interesting call for us.
Let's do it.
All right. So we're pulling the information from the realtor as we speak. We've got.
Yeah. Well, we can explain to everyone how we're finding the phone numbers. We're just highlighting the names and going on Google.
That's it. Everything we do on this call is with free resources. I have cell phone.
Do you find agents struggle to give your lower offer, Rosanna? Yes, I do. You just got to talk to a lot of agents. That's the thing. It's all in volume. This is a massive volume business. So you got to talk to not 10 realtors. You're going to talk to thousands of realtors, and you're going to get dozens of deals. That's how it works. Thousands. All day, every day. This is what I did. This is how I made it.
4-4.
Kevin asked about the funding. Well, if you're wholesaling, you don't need any funding. If you're wholesaling a piece of real estate, I'll give you an example. Let's just say on that call, I write an offer as the buyer, Targ buys houses or assignee for $70,000. They accept it. I call Mike. Hey, Mike, I got this awesome deal for $90,000. Do you want it? Mike is a fix and flip investor. Mike buys it, and I get the difference in the contracts. One contract's at 70, one contract's at 90, which means I made a wholesale fee of $20,000 without risk. I didn't have to get a loan. I didn't have to fix a house, and I didn't have to put in money. All right, Mike, did you get it?
Yep. The number's highlighted on the screen right there.
All right. 1-425-652-6473.
And it looks like Rochay Boston is the realtor on the property.
Rochay or John?
Sure. Yeah. John L. Scott looks like the brokerage.
Where do you get the contract? Your student center at homeschooled.
Thanks for calling. You have reached Rache with John L. Scott Real Estate and the Rache team. If you're calling Monday through Friday between the hours of 8 a.m. and 12 noon, all calls will be returned after 1 p.m. If you're calling on Saturdays, all calls...
All right, I think we got to call someone else.
Yeah, that was... that's her number. I thought I had a brokerage number. We'll see if somebody wants to pick up. see if I can find that.
And it's important you guys always talk to the listing realtor. And here's what happens for most people. They'll make their first call. The realtor says, oh, I'll help you find a house. And then the realtor starts sending you all this junk and you stop looking for, you're never going to find a house like that. The way to get deals is to go directly to the listing agent. And what happens is that if an agent wants to represent you as your buyer's agent, it's just, you're wasting your time. You're spinning your tires.
Hey, Tark, here's the, yeah, there we go. There's the office. We want to see if somebody wants to pick up there. That was the bird. Let's see if.
No one's going to pick up. It's already, it's 5:30 here. It's almost 8 o'clock there.
In Seattle. No, this is in Seattle.
Oh, this is in Seattle. Yep. Ah, okay. Let's try it. By the way, everybody, I would never call an office. Hi, is Rache Boston in? Do you know if John is in? I think they have a listing on 22nd Avenue in Seattle.
Do you have a last name?
Yeah, John, Mike, let me, what's the last name? Can you scroll on the screen? John Scott?
Oh, that's our business, our company name.
Oh, well, okay, there you go. Okay, I didn't get enough sleep last night, apparently. All right.
So I can go ahead and just transfer you to receive some stuff on the
first. Sure. Okay. And this is much easier when you have a headset and it's automated through the computer, auto dialing.
Thanks for calling. You have reached Rache.
All right. Let's go on Zillow. Let's bang out some calls. I'm ready.
Let's do the next one. Houston. All right. Let's jump to Houston. This one looks promising. It's a 5-bedroom, 1-bath, and they're at 180.
All right. Well, we might need to take one of those bedrooms and turn it into 2 bathrooms.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. So Michelle Argo. How long has it been on the market?
It says 3 days. And Targ, I would be surprised if it was only 3 days. That looks like a relist. There we go. And there's our mobile number. And hopefully everybody's seeing, like, we're literally just highlighting and Googling.
Yeah, you guys, this is the key to real estate investing. If you can do this, nothing else matters. Meaning, if you find a deal, you can call people like me, you can call people like our active students, and we will buy these things. This is what we do. This is what we teach. Okay, so I'm calling,
Michelle.
Oh, I lost it.
Oh, let's go back.
832-580-8920. What's the name? Michelle. All right, let's go back to the property. There we go. It says additional repairs to be completed. What does the description say? Right there? Oh. When did it last sell, Mike? Hey, Michelle, this is Tariq El Moussa. I was calling about your listing on East Lake Street in Houston.
Yes.
How you doing tonight?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good, pretty good. I was calling because I noticed this property came up a couple days ago, and I was really interested in purchasing the property and having you represent me.
Okay. All right. Well, right now I'm in the middle of negotiating 6 contracts.
Oh my gosh, you have 6. You have 6 offers already?
Yes.
Okay. Well, before I wouldn't want to waste your time if you're working so many offers. Are you at list or above yet?
Right about at list. Yes.
Got it. All right. Well, you know, let me ask you this question. Because of course you've seen the house. How much do you think it would take to get this house sell ready?
Well, you know we can't get an estimate.
No. Like a remodel. Do you think it needs 30,000 in work, 50,000 in work?
Well, I can tell you that the bathroom is completely demolished. The kitchen is demolished, so that's probably low end.
25.
Yeah, 15 and 10 maybe. But the kitchen is really small, so it's not like you're going to put a massive amount of cabinets in there. Take off the tub in the front yard.
Tub in the front yard parties, those are fun.
Yeah, and it's still in good shape. It's 1956 cast iron, you know. They have the new electrical. They have the flooring, and it's all leveled. All the sheetrock is up.
Like, when did this last sell?
Needing finishing.
Okay, so was it an investor bought it to flip it and then they changed? No, okay, maybe you could tell me.
Yeah, it's a single owner that has owned it since the 60s, I think.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so single owner. Okay, and then once this house was fixed up, you know, new kitchen, new bath, paint, if I said, you know, hey, Michelle, I want you to sell it for me, what do you think it would resell for in today's market?
With the square footage that it has, and if it's completely fixed up, you're looking at about 243 to 280.
Okay, so at 180 purchase, probably 15 works, going to put me at 230, 15 in selling cost, 245, 20 in carrying cost. So I'd have a break even of 265 on this thing. Okay, well, yeah, it might be better for like a more of like a handyman buyer to come in and do the work themselves and do some sweat equity on this thing.
Yeah, most likely.
Yeah, most likely. Well,
the market here is increasing probably 12% per year.
Wow.
At least.
Wow. Is it still hot right now, even with the interest rates? Really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so Houston's hot, not from the heat.
Oh, well, yeah, we're hot from the heat, too.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a very hot properties. I haven't really seen it go down, and I've been in real estate since 99. So wow. I haven't really seen it ever rock bottom. The 80s, but that was way before me.
Yeah.
This market is just always hot.
Yeah. I mean, it looks like it. So that's actually very, very exciting news. So Houston is still on fire. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to run some numbers on this one. If I think I can make it work, I'll definitely reach back out and let you know. But while I have you on the phone, you know, I typically buy 20 to 30 houses a month. I mean, are there any other deals off market or distressed properties you can think of that you could sell me?
Ooh, they come up and go so fast, I hate to say it. I do have one that a fellow agent was asking about. It was for actually a family member. I'd have to get the information for you and then give you a call back.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
I don't know any particulars on it. She just put out an alert that she needed a fast sale.
Well, I'm a very fast buyer. Do you watch HGTV at all?
I don't have time for that.
Have you ever heard of any of my shows like Flip or Flop or Flipping El Moussa's or Flipping 101?
That's you?
Yeah, Tariq El Moussa. I had a blonde wife and I have a new blonde wife, but both blonde.
You have a new baby.
Yes, Tristan. He's 6 months old. Wait, is it the 31st yet? It's almost his birthday. Six more days.
Until they're two.
Yeah. He's actually downstairs right now with Heather. He's doing a little bath time.
All right. Okay, congratulations.
Well, thank you. Well, I really want to get into the Houston market, and it sounds like you do some good business there. And I would really like to be your first phone call when you come across a deal. So this is my personal cell number. If you could save this, I would love to work with you.
Great. I would love to work with you too.
Okay, awesome. Well, yeah, if you can reach out to your coworker and just text me those details on the property, this is my cell, and we could go from there.
All right, fantastic.
All right, well, thank you so much. Have a great night.
Sure, thanks, you too.
Okay, that one wasn't as good. That was a good one though, you guys. That was a good call. Okay, did you see how much information we got? There's six offers on the property. So I already know I'm not competing against six other people. I'm not going to make enough money. It's a waste of my time. I want to find the ones where I don't have to compete against six other people. And that's why I asked the question, do you have any others? And there's a maybe. So we got two good calls today. Now I want you guys to ask yourself this question. If Tariq El Moussa sat here from 8 a.m. till 8 p.m. 5 days a week all year long, is he going to get 40, 50 deals? Yeah. Are you going to get 40, 50? Maybe not your first year, but can you get, you know, 5 or 10? I think so. I really think so. Okay. This is not, I'm telling you, high school algebra is more difficult than what I just did. And I know right now you're thinking, but after that, it's so confusing. You guys, I got the worst ADHD in the world. I figured out to hire everybody to help me because I'm easily confused. I'm telling you guys, if you can figure out how to get the deals, the rest is easy. You just join a homeschool. We'll tell you, sell it to this student or wholesale it here, or we'll partner with Tariq. Like, what? I partner with students. Like, we will always create opportunities for you. If you are doing your job, and your job is to find deals, your job is not to build CRMs, your job is not to be a social media influencer, your job is not to build logos, your job is not to build websites. Your job as real estate investors is to talk to people that own houses or talk to people that sell houses. Is that pretty? I mean, it's pretty simplified, right? You need to talk to two groups of people, one that sell them and one that own them. We can all do that, right? And all you do, and by the way, was I hard selling this real estate agent? Was I abrasive? No, I was nice. I was fun. I was asking questions. Sales is nothing more than asking a series of questions to get you to the result that you want. That's what sales is. You're never going to convince someone to do something they don't want to do. You're never going to force someone to do something they don't want to do. So your job is to know what questions to ask. And we are looking for a needle in a haystack. So how do we find the needle, everybody? We got to move a lot of hay, right? What are we doing tonight? Making these phone calls. This is moving the hay until we find a deal. All right, let's do another one. This is fun. You guys having fun yet? Am I boring anybody yet?
I think we're doing well. I think we're doing well. These have been great conversations.
This is fun tonight. I'm having fun with you guys.
All right, one more in Houston, and then we're going to go into California. All right. So we are calling Juan Torres, and that is the number. So it says, to speak with Juan, call 281-893.
Oh, sorry.
You're good. 9660.
It's been a busy day. I think I'm due for a break soon.
I mean, you were here with a giant camera crew and a behind-the-scenes guest, and we had visitors today, and you did two meetings before this call. I don't think you worked enough today, Tariq.
I almost died in hot yoga today, by the way. It was so hot. Oh my gosh. And anyways, if all of you want to feel better, start doing hot yoga. I promise, spiritually, mentally, physically, your life will change. Okay. Who are we calling? Ghostbusters?
We are calling Juan Torres. Coach Jason used to drag me to hot yoga all the time. That was like his favorite thing to do, is torture me in hot yoga.
Oh, you're going with me Wednesday, Mike. Perfect.
All right, I'll go.
Okay, Juan Torres. Let's look at the, I got the number. If we can see the house, let's look at the pictures of the house real quick. This is close to being a rental. Pretty close. How long has it been on the market?
44 days, I think.
And no price reductions.
Yeah.
All right, let's live a little. And this is in Houston. Why is it not selling? I thought Houston was hot. You see, you guys, we learn from the local realtors. You learn from other people. They're smart ones. They're the ones out selling houses. Ask them. You want to know how the market's doing? Call a realtor that sells in the market. What's the name? Juan? Juan.
Thank you for calling SIS Group, your total insurance solution. All calls can be monitored or reported for all purposes. I am currently unavailable. Please leave a detail.
I think that was a wrong number.
No, that he's with the SIS Group.
Oh.
That is part of his profile. So it looks like, let's see. Yeah, let's call. I think that's.
Oh, right there.
Yeah, let's try that.
1-832-290. If you guys only know, I'm literally working off a laptop and a cell phone right now. This is so archaic and old school. Like, you guys, with the technology today, there's automated systems where you plug it into a dialer and it feeds your headset. Like, it's so much easier. All right. Hello? Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, hey, how's it going? Is this Juan?
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on, Juan? This is Tariq El Moussa. I was calling about your Hirsch Road listing. I'm a buyer.
Okay.
Give me a call. I was interested in purchasing the property as an investment and having you represent me in the offer.
Yeah, $150,000 offer.
What's 150?
He's, no, that's what I'm saying.
He's giving me attitude already.
That's what they offer.
Oh, okay. So you're getting offers at about 150,000. Is that what you said?
Yeah, from.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
look like that. No, I mean the way the seller is not looking at those offers.
Oh, okay. So the seller just wants more than the properties are selling for right now?
Well, the property on the time, more than when we have it listed.
Got it. Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
All right. So immediately, unmotivated. The agent was bothered by the fact that I said I was an investor. They said, what are you going to offer, 150? And I was thinking, yeah. And then bottom line is there's only one reason why a house doesn't sell. It's not the paint. It's not the kitchen. It's not the neighborhood. It's the price. It's the only reason a house doesn't sell. Okay. We got a good, like a wide variety of calls tonight. This is good.
Yeah. I think we're going to start going into California. We found a couple in the Bakersfield area that we think would be great to call on. We know the market's been great here. So,
and then, hey, Mike, I'm going to run through a couple questions really quick while we're looking.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And let's look at like Riverside or San Bernardino County, 60 plus days on market. I think that'd be a good starting point. Tariq, a lot of people are calling as well, with the seller and agent be getting the same message. Don't ever worry about what other people are doing. I've never one time in my entire career ever thought about other people calling. Always focus on yourself and what you need to do. Ignore the noise. Another example is people say, well, how can I flip in Orange County? How can I compete with Tariq El Moussa? Well, how can Tariq El Moussa compete with Zillow? Like when you say it like that, well, he can't. Or can he? You see, there's always a way. So the truth is most people, they're not going to call. Like they're not going to call. The amount of people calling is much lower. And you got to remember, if less people are calling, the odds of you getting a deal are that much greater. But again, you're not going to call two people. You're not going to call five people. You're not going to call 20 people. You're going to tell yourself, I will be a real estate investor no matter what. And I'm going to have thousands of conversations. That's the metric. Now, if you haven't had one deal after 5,000 conversations, yeah, you could quit. That's fine. All right. So Tracy, I take risk. I'll call whoever. Exactly. Just call realtors and call homeowners. That's all you got to call. That's it. Literally two groups of people. Southwest Florida. Yeah, the whole country. Oh, yeah. 108 degrees. Someone asked me how I would fix it up. Well, most likely right now, I would wholesale this property. And if I wanted to fix it up, I would go onto Google and I would Google fix and flip contractors in Houston. And then I would call local real estate agents that work with investors and ask them if they have any contractor referrals. And then I would call property management companies and I would ask them for contractor referrals. You see, this is something that's very important. It's not how, it's who. And there's actually a book about it. You don't need to know how to fix up a house. You need to know who knows how to fix up a house, right? I don't know anything about construction. They got a 2x4, a 4x4, a 6x5. I mean, I know nothing because I've hired contractors. And the reason I hired contractors is because I knew I make more money as an investor than I would as a contractor. So remember, utilize other people's skills and talents. The name of the book is Who, Not How. So next time you don't know how to do something, I don't want you guys to say, I don't know how to do this. It's impossible. I want you to say, who knows how to do this? I'll give you an example. When I wanted to start one of my companies a while back, it was a lot of legal, SEC, all this stuff, overwhelming. And like, you know, some of my, you know, my friends were like, well, how are you going to do this, that? And then one day I was like, I'm going to call a lawyer who works with these type of companies. I called the lawyer, said, hey, I want to start this new company. Can you help me? They said, yeah. And this lawyer walked me through the process of all the legal paperwork, the filings, the rules, the regulations. Who, not how. All right, Mike, let's make some calls. What do we got?
Grace, first of all, Grayson, one of the strategists here at Homeschooled, along with Sheila and some of the other strategists on the call, join us every week. They're constantly looking at how people build their real estate investing businesses. They do calls to take a look at what it means for you to build out a business. Grayson just found this house, Tarek. First of all, there's a tarp on the roof. Just want to call that out. But it's got curb appeal. The inside looks like it needs some work. And it's been on the market for 89 days. This is in Riverside. This house looks sick. Like, this is definitely a we need to call this one.
Yeah, this
look at this thing.
that's about 250 to 300 grand of work right there.
Yeah, let's pull the comps though. I'm liking this one. Let's see.
Yeah, this is a good 250, 300 because it's a historic house. There's probably going to be rules. It's probably going to have foundation issues.
Quadplex.
Well, I think it was meant to be a quadplex. They converted it to a house. Yeah.
Present has five bedrooms, two baths, tall ceilings, craftsman.
Fire in the attic. Raymond Baltazar. All right. Do we have a number for Mr. Raymond? So I can tell you guys right now here. Okay. So here are some of the red flags. The first red flag is it showed that they're giving a 2% commission. You see that buyer agency fee, 2% commission. Another red flag, it's been on the market for a while. And another red flag is they've had no price reductions, which tells me they're not very motivated. Well, it's a red flag because they're giving a 2% commission. And typically the standard is 2.5 to 3. So they're being cheap on the commission, which tells me they might be cheap on, or they might be overpriced. All right, his number is 951. 555. All right, Mike, let's go back to the, there we go. What's the name?
Raymond.
Hi, is this Raymond?
Yes, sir.
Hey, Raymond, this is Tariq El Moussa. I was calling about your listing on University Avenue in Riverside.
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm a local real estate investor. I was interested in purchasing this property and having you represent me. And I was just wondering if I could ask you a couple questions.
Let me put my head on.
Sure.
Can you hear me now, sir?
Yes, sir, I can.
Okay. Shoot away, sir.
Just giving a call because I was interested in purchasing it and having you represent me. But I was wondering, can I ask you a couple quick questions?
What do I mean, sir?
Okay. Do you currently have any offers on the house?
Yes, sir, I do. I've received many offers on the home. My client, he wants to like a week, yes, okay. So we turned down offers north of $500,000.
Wow.
And have you seen the property yet?
I haven't seen it in person, but I'm looking at the pictures. I'm guessing it needs about $225,000 to $250,000 in work.
I think you're very close to that, and you're right there. I think you can get by with $200,000 and make it really look good. I mean, super good. And there's also, I don't know if you know, a three-car garage in the back, which I would convert that into an ADU or income property.
Yeah, definitely an ADU, especially with the new junior ADU laws.
Right.
Yeah. So I do have a question. So if this house was fixed up, right, new roof, new kitchen, new baths, ADU, the whole thing, what do you think it would sell for in the Riverside market there?
I think about $750,000 to $800,000.
Okay, 750. So let's just say on the high, it would be eight. So let's if I bought it for five and I did the ADUs, I put 250 into it. So five plus 250 puts me at 750. I got about 50 in selling costs, 800. I have about 50 in carrying. So I'd have a break even of 850. So I'd lose money if I paid 500.
But here's the take on it. As a buyer, with money that the city of Riverside has right now, they're giving grants out to get homes back into shape.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's something you might want to look at as a buyer.
Got it. Okay. So, yes. You know,
being it's historical Riverside, and it is on University. I'm not. Don't hold me to it, but I've been told there's monies out there, and I mean monies that they want to keep the historical look of the home, but yet upgraded with all the modern fixtures.
Yeah. Which I've done many of those. They get quite expensive because they require sometimes like real wood windows and things like that. So I mean. Would your seller ever consider like an all cash offer at like 450, 475?
No, he's already turned those down already.
Got it. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a little bit more research into the grants to see if I can come up with something. But while I have you on the phone, because I am an active buyer, do you have any other distressed properties or fixer-uppers that you have listed or that are off market or maybe someone in your office?
Well, honestly, I don't have anything at the moment. I've got some things coming up. I wish you would have called me 6 months ago. I had plenty of places up here in West Riverside, in Harupa Hills on the golf course.
Yeah.
Which I had, and they needed some money. And I wish you were around. I could have taken care of you then.
All right. Well, I'm around now. And so here's the interesting thing. I'm actually from SoCal. I live in Orange County. We buy 20 to 30 houses a month. You might have seen one of my shows. Do you watch HGTV at all?
Of course I do. You're one of my heroes on TV. I shoot you all the time.
Okay, so you know my shows. Okay, good. All right, so here's what we got to do.
I've been following you for years.
Okay, good.
I've always thought about this when you come to River, when you picked Riverside. I think you did something up there on Van Buren years ago.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did a couple projects up there.
And I know I've got a mid-century home right there in Harupa Hills. The first home built in Harupa Hills, and it's octagon shape, and it's so cool. So, but anyway, sir, what I would do is I will run that by him.
Okay.
About 475.
Yeah, and I'm just throwing it out there, and I'd have to do a 4.75, 6.75, 7.25. Yeah, I'd have to do a little more due diligence, but you could run it by him for sure.
Okay.
But
you know what? Maybe he would like you to purchase it instead of somebody else, because you know how to make things work.
You know, I'm willing to take a real look at it. So yeah, reach out to your seller, and this is my personal cell phone number. So whether it's today, tomorrow, next week, next month, or next year, if you come across any deals, if you text me, I'll get back to you immediately.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay. So yeah, I would love to be your investor buyer moving forward. Maybe we go grab lunch or something.
Okay. Perfect. I appreciate that. And good luck with everything, and congratulations on the baby.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. He's doing a little bath time right now. I'm going to go hang out with him in a little bit.
Okay. Let me speak to him, and I will shoot you a text tomorrow.
Okay. Awesome.
Okay, sir.
All right. Well, you have...
Call me, okay?
Yeah, yeah. Have a great night.
Good night.
All right. That was a fun call. So, do you guys see what I did right there on the phone? I went over the math. So, I'll tell you the math I did. When you're evaluating a piece of real estate, the first thing you want to find out, it's not about the sales price or asking price. The first thing you want to find out is what is the highest this house can sell for once it's fixed up. So I asked the question, once this house was fixed up, what can it sell for? He said $800,000. We know it's going to take $250,000 in remodel to make it look like an $800,000 house. So we take $800,000 minus $250,000 to fix it up, puts us at $550,000. We know we're going to have to pay 6% commission and closing costs when we sell the house on $800,000. So 6% on $800,000 is $48,000. Let's just call it $50,000. So we take $800,000 ARV minus $250,000 to fix it up, puts us at $550,000. We just said we have $50,000 in closing costs and commission. So then we take $550,000 minus $50,000 to sell it, puts us at $50,000. So what did we just learn? We learned that if I bought that house for $500,000, I fixed it up and I sold it with a realtor, I'm going to make $0. I'm not in the business of making $0. So we've identified my break-even. My break-even is $500,000. So if I pay $500,000, I make zero. I don't want to make zero. So then my offer is going to be probably 400. Does that make sense? So it's a very simple mathematical formula. ARV minus rehab minus selling, find your break even, pick your profit. If I wanted to make a huge profit, I could offer 300. If I wanted to make a smaller profit, I could offer 425. But this house is a big project, so I would want a bigger profit. If it was an easy, quick flip, well, then if my break even was 500, maybe I'd offer 430 because it's an easier project. Does that make sense? Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do a seventh inning stretch, Mike. I'm gonna go use the restroom. I will be back.
All right, we've got a little bit of time. So while Tarek's away, taking a quick break, a lot of you have asked some great questions as well as gone a little deeper than what we do on this call. This is a call to show that real estate investing, if you want to break into the game, can be done with a cell phone and Zillow. Like, we're doing nothing more than going on Zillow or Redfin, looking at how long houses have been on the market. There's a couple of filters we use. The strategist that works with a lot of our students, Grayson, is kind of in the background pulling deals as we go market to market. And we're showing you that you can model what Tarek does to at least begin to build your network and get into real estate investing. A lot of the questions that you are asking are things that we teach and take a deep dive on inside of Homeschooled. So if you are not a homeschooled student, I know we have a ton of students on tonight. Kimmy was on earlier. I saw Teresa Lamb. Stefan, one of our rock stars, is on tonight. What is up, Mr. Valentino? Good to see you. If you are not a student yet and you're interested in looking at what Homeschooled is about, Our strategists are more than happy to do a deep dive call with you and take a look at what your real estate investing business would look like, how we could support you building that real estate investing business. You know, Teresa literally just like popped a deal to us tonight while we were talking. I was like, Teresa, email it to me. Cheryl Stevenson is on. We've looked at deals with Cheryl out in her home state of Nevada. She's one of our rock stars. Her and I had a great talk about a month and a half ago, and she has been crushing it ever since. So if you're interested in looking at what Homeschooled by Tarik looks like, what we teach, what our mentorship is all about, we can absolutely get you on the phone with a strategist. I know Sheila's on tonight. I saw Grayson. I think a couple of the other strategists are on. So if you're interested in that, put your hand up, let us know. We'll send you a link to book in. You can absolutely take advantage of doing a call with our strategist. You know, Grayson is on these calls regularly, helping us look at markets, pull deals. Our strategists are all active real estate investors. I've said this on other calls from the first time since I met Grayson live. He had paperwork for two deals in his hand. He's like, I need a scanner. I got to get this paperwork in. I'm in escrow on two deals. So all of our mentors, all of our strategists, it's not just theory. Tarik brings in people that are active real estate investors to help in the mentorship. So if that's something you're interested in, let us know in the chat. Our strategists are on. They will book you in for calls. We can also, I think if we can, post the links to make sure that they can book in strategy sessions with us. I know that's something that typically after deal finding, a lot of folks want to do, pop in and grab a strategy session. So I'll throw one there in the chat, and I think we can do it. Some of the strategists have their links as well. Oh, there you go. Tammy, another one of our students is on. Tammy's constantly doing deals. So if you want to learn more from Tarik, spend more time with Tarik, have more intimate time like this with Tarik, outside of our live deal finding that we do like this, we've got our mentorship program. More than happy to jump in. We also do live events. We have one coming up called Summer School. I think as of today, we looked and there were like, I don't know, 5 or 6 seats left. I keep saying that, but you know, we sell tickets and I assume we have more space. That is only 40 seats. So it's 40 seats for Summer School. That is an intimate kind of a party night in 2 days here at Tarik's offices. We're going to go live deal finding. We're going to do door knocking with Tarik. We're going to go out onto some of the live construction sites where Tarik is flipping properties for the Flipping El Moussas. So very intimate one-on-one experience with Tarik and his team here at Tarik Buys Houses, where we're at tonight. So book in with your strategy sessions. Talk to Grayson. Talk to Sheila. Talk to our strategists. Make sure that you're speaking with them. And if you're interested in summer school, the link is there as well. We will drop a link for strategy session. And I think Mr. El Moussa is back. All right. We do every once in a while let you take a break. Oh, you're muted at the moment. Yeah. Sorry. Tarik is muted. There we go. I think we sent you the
back.
There we go. And we're back.
Heather's dream. If I was muted, she just wants me to shut up because I never stop talking.
Oh, and then we go, there is TEM Capital. So the other piece is some of you are interested in investing and getting into larger projects, larger properties. Tarik has TEM Capital that allows you to come into larger opportunities like storage, like, large multifamily.
Yeah, well, we're about to develop 138 units in North Hollywood. We just bought 376 units in Northwest Arkansas. Next week, we're closing on 215 units in Orlando. We're developing 202,000 square feet of self-storage in Surprise, Arizona. And by the way, 13 years ago, I was splitting $5 footlongs and stealing lemonade in water cups. So I say that because anything is possible. I'm serious, you guys. 13 years ago, I couldn't afford lunch. Today, we're buying 300 and 400 unit buildings. I'm going to answer this question real quick. Johnny Foe, Tarik, I have no issue finding deals to fix or flip. I hustle every day, AM tonight. The problem is I can't purchase all those homes. Now, how can I go about to maximize potential without losing deals I work hard on? Very simple. You should 100%, if you're finding deals, you're putting in the work, you got to join homeschool so we can teach you what to do. You start off as a real estate investor, and then you go to someone that owns a real estate investing company, and then you go to a passive income investor. So there's a process to real estate investing. Yes, as of right now, to get involved, in my bigger commercial deals, you would have to be an accredited investor. So if anyone's an accredited investor, these are exceptional deals that I personally vetted and I'm personally invested in. So I'd love to have you if you are an accredited investor. All right.
Love it. All right. Do we want to look at our next property, Tark?
Let's do it.
All right. Let's go. That one looks oof. Maybe. Let's pull that one.
I haven't seen it yet.
No, it's coming. Hang on. We're turning the screen share on. All right. So this is in Santa Paula, California. 5-bedroom, 2-bath. And man, this thing looks beautiful. It's messy.
It needs a little paint. It's fine.
little paint. Anybody that wants to take a bath in that bathroom, you go ahead. And let's scroll. How many days has this been on market? I think. This one fell out of escrow, Tarek. So there may be an interesting opportunity.
More motivation. Whenever they fall out of escrow, they're typically more motivated.
This was posted by someone on the call, and I apologize. I forgot who posted it. If the person who posted it wants to put their hand up, there we go.
Sochi? Did I say the name right? Sochi? I knew a girl named Sochi in high school. It's spelled like that. Yes. Oh my God.
Do you want to come on camera? If you put your hand up, we can bring you up. If you want to tell us a little bit more about the property and how you found it.
Chrissy Seal, I see you. Sochi, you want to come say hi? Coach Tarek, he's here.
Let's see. Even if you just come off mute, and say hello.
Wait a minute. Is Raquel going for a run while listening? This is just beautiful. you've been listening on my calls. She's been listening. Kill 2 birds with 1 stone. Go for walks every night. Make your phone call while you exercise.
Let me see if I can.
I love it. Makes me so happy.
Asked to start video. Oh, I don't see it. It's not allowing me to unmute more and ask to start video. There we go.
Did it work?
Yes.
You're live.
I'm live. Okay.
Hi, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I don't see her though, Mike. Do we just have audio?
Not on video.
Okay.
I'm not on video. Let's see. Am I on video now? There I am.
Bingo.
Hi. So sure. I actually, Tarek, have been following you. I've watched your shows, obviously, but I've been following you, I don't know, probably I think since 2020. And so I'm always hopping on and everything else. I ended up getting my real estate license. I'm just slowly getting into the market. So this is a house in Santa Paula. I'm from Fillmore. I'm actually the one that put in the address, and you spoke to Oscar on the last Zoom. Do you remember?
Yeah.
Yes.
The seller, is that the seller carry guy?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, he called me and I was working it, but then yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, absolutely. So I just, you know, every time I Zoom with you, I get onto the MLS and I look for the ugliest house on the block. And so I keep typing in addresses, and the last two, this is the second one that you've actually looked at, but I don't know anything about the property. I just looked it up really quick and then typed in the address.
Well, let's just call and see what happens. But what I want you to start doing is calling yourself, though. I'm telling you,
okay,
your life will change. You can do the things you want to do. And like, I just want to say this really quick, everybody. I've been thinking about money lately. This is not about money, okay? And there's such this weird stigma around money. Money is a tool to reduce stress and create happiness. That's how I view money. Money is a tool. And if you really think about our lives, why do people get divorced? Why are people a lot of times bad parents? Why are people always, they're money problems. So if we can figure out how to eliminate our money problems, we live a much better life. I mean, and I've been broke, you guys, and it's much better to have some money, not because money and flashy crap. It's because all the stresses and anxieties of paying your rent and your car and your gas, like all of that goes away. So you can actually be happy. So yes.
And then once you have money, you can help people just as you're doing by helping and teaching all of us.
Absolutely.
It makes it more joyous.
Yeah, you got to pay it forward. You know, yeah. The interesting thing about me is I went to my first training seminar, my first ever live event. I was 20 years old. And I left that event saying, one day I'm gonna become a big hit in this real estate industry. And one day I'm gonna teach others. And today's my day. I can't tell you how grateful I am to be able to be on here with you guys, teaching you guys, mentoring you guys. It is a dream of mine and it makes me so happy, like for real. So thank you.
Thank you.
Very welcome. All right, let's call. Who are we gonna call? Timothy Davis.
As long as it's not Oscar again, we're okay. Because that just went left. No, I'm teasing. That was good.
He's quite a character.
He was great.
All right, who am I asking for? Nate? Tim.
Timothy.
Where's Santa Paula?
Santa Paula, 15 minutes from Ventura County, from Ventura, the beaches.
Tim. This is Tim. Hey, Tim, how you doing? This is Tariq El Moussa. I was calling about your listing on Telegraph Road.
Yes.
How you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine. And you?
I'm doing pretty good. The day's just wrapping up here. I did see this property and it looks like it's exactly what I'm looking for. So just giving you a call to ask a couple questions real quick, see if maybe we can write an offer on this thing.
Well, right ahead.
Do you have any offers on it right now?
Multiple.
Oh, you do have multiple offers on it right now. Okay.
Yes.
I see that it was listed for a little bit of time. Did it ever go into escrow and fall out?
Yes, it did.
And do you by any chance know why it fell out of escrow?
Yeah, the buyers didn't communicate with their hard money lender.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, he wanted 35% down payment and they didn't have it.
Well, that's a big down from a hard money lender.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So
I don't know any reasoning why, but we were in escrow at 500K. We had, I think, 12 or 14 offers originally. And we sent the best three out to best and final, and they came in at 500K.
Wow.
And we took it.
Well, yeah, I would too.
No contingencies, liquidated damages released at the beginning or opening of escrow.
Wow.
That's what they wanted. So unfortunately, they couldn't.
They just couldn't perform. And that's actually happening a lot right now. Because I buy like 20 to 30 houses a month. And a lot of times, you know, I'll write an offer and I'll compete against offers where they're, you know, 50,000 or 100,000 higher. And then a lot of times they come back to me because they know that I'll actually close on the deal, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So you said you had six offers?
I think we got somewhere around there. Yes.
Okay. Would you be able to represent me if I did write an offer?
I have no problem with that.
No problem with that. Okay, perfect.
I mean, just to be honest with you, we're going to be somewhere around 450 this time around.
Okay, so you think it'll get bid up to like 450?
Yes.
So let me ask you a question. So, I mean, based on the condition right now, like how much would you say it would cost to fix this house up, make it turnkey, new roof, siding, flooring, landscaping, bathrooms, kitchen, everything?
Yeah, you know, people ask me that question all the time, and it depends on what you do. I mean, if you put in Home Depot kitchen and Home Depot bathrooms and all that, you could get it done for, I don't know, if you've got a crew of 100 grand. If you're going to pay somebody to do it all top end, you're going to spend three.
All right. So you know the business, don't you? I like that.
Yeah, been around.
Yeah. So I would hire generals. It would cost me on this house, I would say probably 160, 170.
And if you're going to flip it, there's not that much margin in it.
Yeah. That's
take 450 and you add 150, you're at six.
Yeah, exactly. And what do you think it would sell for?
Somewhere around six.
Okay, got it. Yeah, so this wouldn't work for me, but it sounds like, I mean, you definitely got a couple buyers on the hook, which is fantastic. So while I have you on the phone, I do love buying properties, especially in California. Do you have any other properties you can think of that are distressed, off market, maybe a coworker?
I don't have coworkers. My business motto is mostly probate and trustee sales, and they are required to be on the market to the general public for a certain, for a reasonable amount of time. So off-market properties, just, I don't do them. I can't do them.
Okay.
So, but fixers I get all the time.
Okay. So this is my cell phone number. Next time you get a fixer, after it's listed, if it hasn't sold or the buyer's backing out, do you think you would be able to give me a call and if I can get you a cash offer within a couple hours?
Sure.
Okay, perfect. So I'm going to text you my email. And this is my personal cell phone. And my name is Tariq El Moussa.
Yeah, I've heard the name.
Okay. So maybe you've seen the shows. Okay, awesome.
Yes, I probably have. Don't watch a whole lot of them, but yeah, I think I've seen some of them.
All right. Very, very neat. Well, it was great chatting with you. And I hope this one works out. And I look forward to doing a deal with you.
All right. Have a good evening.
All right. You too. Thank you.
Bye.
All right. So they have too many offers. So here's, if anything, so I'll talk to Sochi for a second. If anything, think about what I just did. I was not an expert at all. He told me the rehab. He told me the ARV. He told me what he thought it was going to sell for. And he told me it wasn't a good flip. All from asking questions. So just, it's about getting them on the phone. So we got to make those phone calls. We got to go those reps in. And the more conversations you have, the more leads you generate. The more leads you generate, the more deals you get. The more deals you get, well, the more money you're going to make. All right, that was fun. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I love it.
It's like The Price is Right. Yeah, it is, exactly. Man,
we've got a couple more, Tark. I want to say something. We were just talking in the office. I turned and I said, is Karen Estrada one of our homeschooled students? Because I see her face all the time. And the team said no, but this is like her 8th deal finding session that she's been on. I just want to, Karen, your dedication, the notes, you're constantly on. I can tell you're learning. Like, we just wanted to say hi. The team was just like, oh my gosh, like she's got such a pleasant face. Thank you for joining us regularly and being like a constant student. Really, really good stuff. I got the thumbs up from her. That was really cute. Now we have, Tark, the next one's in Simi.
Hey, Mike, we're going till 6:30?
Yep, we've got one more.
Okay, yeah. I got baby duty next.
Baby duty? What's that all about?
Yeah, well, I got a baby in the house.
Speaking of Simi, I'm going to drive to Simi right after we're done. It's coming. This will be our last call. So this one has a $50,000 price cut. It's been on the market for, I think, 54 days, it said. Seven? Oh, the one in Yucaipa was the 54 days. Okay.
This isn't a good candidate. So they just dropped the price as like a trick if it was only just listed. And also it's a healthcare facility. Yeah, this one wouldn't be.
Oh no. Okay, we didn't see that. What about the one in Yucaipa? Am I saying that right?
Yes.
Okay. So this one's been on for 54 days and has a $25,000 price cut. Currently presents as two single family residences on one lot. Proof plans will convert this to a single family ADU and junior ADU.
Let's live a little. Let's call big them. Lot.
Let's see if we can go out with a bang. All right, there's the number. We're calling Ryan Mitchell.
Or is it Joel Espinoza?
I think the number is Ryan's number.
Oh. All right.
We'll look for Joel's as well.
I agree, Brian, with Ethan Realty Group.
All right, Mr. Mike, I see we answer a couple questions.
All right, we've got about 5 minutes. Does anybody have a burning question for Mr. Almusa? If you do, please put your hand up and we can bring you on. Doreen McQueen, and then we will go back to Harry. Doreen, if you can, I'm going to put you on. Doreen, you are one of our homeschooled students.
Hey, Doreen.
If you can come off mute.
And I want to say this really quick, everybody. The most valuable asset we have in life is not money, it's time, mm-hmm. right? So we're all fighting for time. Well, why do we want money? So we have more time, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and time is just so valuable. So we have to make sure that we're always maximizing our time and we're doing things that are going to bring return on our time. And real estate investing is one of those things where if you put in the time, you're going to get that return. It compounds. It's just all about getting started. And it honestly, it blows my mind sometimes to read some of the comments from people. Oh, I'm finding leads. I'm getting deals, but I'm getting too many and I don't want to do with them. It's like, you guys, just so you understand, that's exactly why I built this program, to create shortcuts, to take time off your learning so you can get to success faster. The entire goal of homeschooled is to help you find success faster. And if you find success faster, you find earning faster, and then your life changes faster. Does that make sense? Speed.
Yes,
speed. Yes. Shortcuts and speed. All right. How you doing, Doreen?
Hey, Tarek, how are you?
Doing good.
Good, good. Okay, so I saw somebody said something about, you know, if you're going to wholesale starting out, do it in the city in which you live or the area in which you live. I wanted to know, I'm in Georgia, but I have a son who lives in New Jersey. And while you were looking, I was on Zillow looking for some properties, you know, just to make sure, you know, because I tried this before looking on Zillow and I couldn't find anything. I was so frustrated. And so tonight I found three in New Jersey, in Camden, New Jersey, in the retail area, and they look pretty good. So my question is, if I have somebody with boots on the ground there, is it okay if I do it there and here? Starting out.
It is 100% okay. Just so you know, it's always going to be a little bit easier on your home turf because you know the neighborhoods, you know the communities, you know the trends. So if you're going to go out of state, totally fine. Just make sure you do your due diligence. So
yeah,
here's an example. If you wanted to go buy a deal in New Jersey,
mm-hmm.
I would have you bring it to Thursday night deal review so my team can look at it to make sure we like the numbers.
Okay.
And then two, I would want you to get at least three expert opinions from local real estate agents on the future value of the house once it's fixed up.
Okay. So two properties that I'm looking at are commercial.
All right.
One is a multifamily and one is single family. Well, actually two of them are single, a multifamily, and one is a commercial. I know the area, I lived there, grew up there, but yes, I will get in contact with the agents in the area to find out, you know, what the values are looking like and that kind of thing.
Yeah, I'll always go to the experts and get their opinions and go to multiple experts.
Okay, thank you so much.
That's the beautiful thing about our industry. We're the investors, we're not the experts. They're the experts, let them tell us. Let's get help. It's a helping industry.
And Tara, she said a couple interesting things. One, she has boots on the ground. Two, she's familiar with the area, which makes out of state or out of area investing a little easier. Doreen, remember, we have a couple coaches in that area and you are one of our students. So knock on Coach Devin's door and Coach Bud's door and Coach Phil's door, because they all live in and around that area. So you have extra boots on the ground being a homeschooled student.
Okay. You said Devin, Phil, and who else?
Coach Bud.
Bud. Oh, okay.
Devin's in Jersey. So, I mean, I would definitely knock on her door.
Oh, and Devin's a rock star. She's a rock star. Well, they're all rock stars. They're fantastic. You know, I don't know if you know what the coolest thing about all of our homeschooled coaches, everyone? This is my favorite thing. Every single one of our homeschooled coaches started off as students. I want you to think about that. Our coaches started out as students just like you.
That's it. Doreen, thank you. Good to see your smiling face again. Love it. All right.
Bye, Tarek.
Tarek, we hit the 6:30 mark. So you tell me, do you have time for one more or is it time to go to the baby?
Do one more.
All right, Harry, you had your hand up since the beginning. So I'm going to bring you up.
He has.
That's it. All right, Harry. I think you are muted, good sir.
There you go.
How's that? All right. First of all, thanks for taking my question. Huge fan here for many years. It's two parts, two questions, and I'll make it quick because I know you got to hurry over there and do diaper duty. Number one is, does TEM Capital, are they making any loans to investors for single family, or is it strictly a multifamily buy-in?
Strictly buying commercial real estate.
Okay. And second question is,
within homeschooled, we have hard money lending partners though.
Okay, great. That's good to know. And the second question is, because I'm looking to do business in many areas of the country, and that is, with the price points in California, and I don't know all the laws there yet. That's going to be something I'm going to need to dive into. But do creative financing deals, are they working out there?
So creative financing deals, again, they'll work anywhere. They'll work anywhere. Okay. Is it more likely to work better in certain markets? Yes. So when you get to like higher price points, more sophisticated sellers, they're going to be less interested in that type of stuff.
Mm-hmm. They have less of a need, so they'll have less motivation to go that direction. All right. Well, thank you so much. Won't keep you any longer. And enjoy your dadship there.
Yeah. Thank you. So, this was a lot of fun. So, everybody, I hope everybody had a good time tonight. And I want to see in the chat, did I prove to you guys that anybody can find deals with a phone and the internet? I want to see it.
100%.
I worked hard for you guys tonight. All right. Now, in the chat, do you think you can do what I did tonight? Just think about it. Can you pick up the phone, call people, and ask 5 to 7 questions? Now, the next question is, what is holding you back from getting started? Why? I'm begging you guys, get started. This business will change your life. It'll change your future. It'll change the trajectory of your family. Better vacations, better schools, better this, less stress, more happiness. Like all of that comes. You just got to put in the work at the beginning. So if you're out there, you guys are ready, book your strategy session. They're totally free. And I would love to coach you guys. As you can see, we have a lot of fun, and you guys will be sick of me by month 3 or 4, probably not. But no, we have a lot of fun, and I got your back. I want your success so bad. We're literally willing to do everything we can to help you climb this mountain of being a real estate investor.
Love it. Ladies and gentlemen, put in the chat a big thank you and show some love for Mr. Tarek L. Moussa. Also for our team behind the scenes, Grayson, Chelsea, Brighton, Coach Jason, Grayson, Sheila, the rest of our strategists. And if you want to have a strategy session, they are ready to talk to you about what your real estate investing business will look like. They'll talk to you about your market, what you can do to get in, how to get started, how to make sure that it's structured in a way that supports your goals, your outcomes for wealth building and for being in real estate. Like Tarek said, it's not just about the money earlier, right? This is about who you're becoming. He says this all the time. This is about becoming a better version of yourself. And this is a vehicle that helps you get there. You know, I think the reason most of us center around Tariq is because Tariq is always pushing us to be our best selves, pushing ourselves way past our limits, but we create magic because of that. And Tariq's shown for over a decade in under the magnifying glass of TV with 90,000 viewers watching him that it's possible.
Brilliant.
All sorts of challenges, right? So, Tariq, you're still on.
you said 90,000 is 90 million.
No, 90 million. But he genuinely wants success for everyone around him. Our team has been talking about this all day today in our on-site meeting. And if you want to be part of that community, come in and join us in real estate investing. Come and be part of a community of people that's supporting each other in growing and getting into deals. Come do your strategy session. Find out what Homeschooled is all about. The links are here. Grayson, who's been on with us, you know, consistently now, you see him constantly on the calls. He's one of our strategists. Sheila is one of our strategists. The rest of the team, pop in. Happy to talk to you guys. Thank you so much for being with us. From everyone at Homeschooled, and obviously from Team Tariq, we appreciate you being here, and we'll see you soon.
Bye, everybody. Thank you. That was fun.